Welcome to the tool shed. So in this tool, I'm going to call it Shining Your Light. I've come to this because lately I've been counseling a lot of people, second half of life, called the afternoon of life, people who have contained their light, their energy, their spirit. In Kabbalah, it's called Ruach. It doesn't matter what you call it. It's that creative juice. It's that life force that's in all of us. But for a thousand reasons, we learn to contain it. We learn to withhold it. Maybe we do it for so long that we lose touch with it. We become detached from it. We lose access to it. There's a thousand reasons we do this. No judgment. We all do this. You know, maybe we're raised in a household where our light needs to be diminished for survival purposes. Too shining, too light, you know, brings attention to you, and you gotta hide in the shadows. Or maybe, you know, you're competing with a sibling and they're outshining you, and so you find a different strategy, and that's withholding. And that's oftentimes in the Enneagram, you become an Enneagram 2, the helper. You become a 9, the peacemaker, to sort of say you're important. They have power. They're the source of light. I call it being the sun and the moon. They're the sun and I'll be the moon. They're the source of light. I'll receive and reflect that light and find my way. And that's perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with it. But then when I'm counseling people midlife onwards and they want to reimagine their lives and they know that there's something calling to them, one of the things we do is we just tap into, where did it go? What is it? Some people have just lost access to it for so long that they don't even know that it's a thing. I mean, when we talk about it and describe it and get into it, they start to wake up and remember it. And that's the key, by the way. It's not about discovering it. It's about remembering it. It's who we are. It's about returning to it. And so really the work, I think, of the second half of life, particularly if you want to, as I say, defy your Enneagram number, defy your personality, defy the ways that you have survived. Surviving is a start, but it's not enough. It is a beginning point. It is not an end point. And when you get to a certain point in life, like midlife and onwards, you don't need to survive. You've made it. You've made it materially, financially, professionally, as a parent, as a spouse. I mean, maybe not all those things, but you know, you may get this far in life. You have something to hang your hat on. And so you start saying, I need more. I want more. I choose more. And I want to shine that light. And here's what happens. We're not comfortable with that light. We have an easier time sort of diminishing it, keeping the shade shut, because that's just our old patterns and it's our old stories and it's what we've been telling ourselves to survive. But you don't have to survive anymore. And so we have to get in touch with that light. We have to get in touch with that energy. We have to become friends with it again. We have to invite it into our life to create opportunities, circumstances where we get to explore it. We get to try it on in new ways. So there's a famous Marianne Williamson quote, and I return to this in my thinking sometimes, but I want to say it explicitly because it really ties this all together and will bring us home. So she says in her book, Return to Love, our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We are all meant to shine as children do. We were born to make manifest the glory of God that is in us. It's not just in some of us, it's in every one of us. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. And that's my experience. So many people at the crossroads, midlife onwards, are holding back their light for fear of the light. And that's what I said before, getting in touch with it, owning it, studying it, mastering it, and then sharing it. And they're afraid because what are the consequences if I switch gears and the Enneagram 2, the Enneagram 9, stepping into the light, becoming the source of light, becoming the sun. Sun is hot. Sun can burn. Sun can melt. So there are consequences to it. I hear this all the time, especially from usually the female spouse in a relationship, but sometimes the males. And if I do that, the marriage might dissolve. We might end up divorced. And what I say to them is, I can't promise you that that's true or not true. But what I can promise you is that if you keep your shades shut, if you withhold your light, the marriage is going to die anyways, because you will grow in resentment of him or her. You will wither on the vine. Your spirit, your soul will just continue to get smaller and smaller. Once you know, you can't unknow. And once you've seen or felt your light, you can't withhold it. Not for anybody, not for your children or your parents, your friends, and not for your spouse. Because in the end, you do not serve them by playing small. You do not serve them by holding back the energy, the light. It doesn't mean you have to flood the place 24/7. It doesn't mean you have to do it too fast and too furious. But you do, at least methodically, step by step, day after day, continue to release more light, expand your light. It can be, again, a thousand ways that you express it. Maybe it's through your art. Maybe it's through, you know, leaving profession and pursuing a passion that you've always wanted. Maybe it's about changing professions and finally doing that thing that you've always wanted to. There's a thousand ways that you can express your light. It doesn't matter. Those are just means. The bottom line is there is a source of light within you, and you do not serve anyone around you by playing small. You do not serve them by holding it back. They may not be able to receive it, and you'll have to cross that bridge when you get there. But again, what is worse than sharing your light with somebody who can't receive it and having to go your separate ways in life is withholding it and watching it and feeling it and knowing that it is diminishing in you day by day, year by year. And losing access to the light is the most destructive path in this life, not just for you, but for those around you. So if you want to serve those around you, if you want to serve your marriage and your friends and your family and your community, then let your life shine. I feel like I should break into a gospel. Let your life shine. Let your light shine and your life shine. And I'm going to put this Marianne Williamson quote in the tool below. Until then, live your spirit, live your passion, live your purpose, shine your light, and I'll see you in the next tool.